measure, analyze, improve, and control. Why control? See, there is only major differences. Another methodology is verify, and first methodology says is control. Control, why to control? In order to stop the defect, because it is related to manufacturing side of the product or services. Here, control is more important, so that if a defect is arising, then you can have control on that particular defect. You can stop the manufacturing. You can stop servicing your customer. You can go for a break. You can what? We have website that stop for what? Renovation, we can call it, or repairing, we can call it. You can repair yourself and again restart. So control is the first methodology which talks about defining the problem, measuring the problem, analyzing the problem, improvising. How to improvise? Again, it does not require plenty of costly equipment. See, Six Sigma says you don't have to change the process, you don't have to change the machineries. What you have to change is the way you are doing it. Maybe there are wastage in terms of the times, transport, as I said, I'll be coming to that, which will clarify your things. You are not supposed to change your entire theme of the setup. So people usually get confused with that. Ki Six Sigma lagaya to mera pura setup, I have to change, I have to bring new machineries. No, not at all. You are supposed to work with your present setup only. That is the beauty and that is the core of Six Sigma. Somebody has rightly asked, there's minimum amount of investment to be done. All you have to do is just find out the core of the problem without changing the sequence, without changing the whatever methodology you have adopted earlier, without changing the techniques, tools and machineries you are having when we talk about manufacturing, or without changing the process when we talk about services. Your process will remain same. You won't be burdened with doing something different than what you were doing earlier, which usually as a human being we are afraid of. I asked to ye kar raha tha. Today I was teaching operation management. Now all of a sudden I am asked to teach accounting, which won't be happening with the Six Sigma. I'm talking from the point of view of teacher. For me, if somebody says, sir, fine, operations kafi padha liya aapne, now start teaching accounting. But if I'm good in operation, then there do not arise a problem of taking accounting. I should perfect. I should improvise and whatever I'm teaching right now. So that is the core philosophy. You are not supposed to change anything. You are supposed to find out just a problem. So second philosophy is related to the customer side of it. DMADV, we call it DMADV. Now this philosophy, thinks from the point of view of customers. What exactly is customers thinking? The complementary side of Six Sigma processes that is more applicable to examining and improving the customer relation. This talks from the customer's point of view. First philosophy was talking from so that we have less defect, zero defect. Here we talk from the customer so that we have less complaints, right? We have speedy delivery, we have fast delivery, we have the customers who are very happy customers, who to a certain extent are loyal customers. So what does this philosophy says? This says our methodology is fine. Again, here we have to define, measure, analyze, and design the technique so that we deliver the product, defectless product, to our customers, who in turn will promote our product, who in turn will be our brand ambassador, who in turn will be our loyal customer, will in turn will form a base for our organization, so that we are sure that this much of orders are going to come each and every month, or maybe quarterly or yearly, depending on what sort of products you are selling, right? And verify what? Verify the design performance and implement this design. This is going to be the last step. So all you have to do is just remember this two methodology, and this is all about Six Sigma. Six Sigma applies this methodology in the situation, in the present situation, without changing the setup drastically. Fine, little bit changes here and there are bound to happen. Maybe a workstation which was earlier was the first workstation can move to second workstation. If we are talking about manufacturing, a bit of changes will take place, but Six Sigma methodology will not change your product. Your product will remain same. Whatever standard you have set for yourself are going to remain same. All you will be doing is just finding out the problems. You will be defining a project, right? And project is nothing but finding out those problems. And mind you again, if the problems are known by management, then there is no again question of implementing Six Sigma. If the management is aware about the problem, then they can themselves sort out those problems. Six Sigma people or Six Sigma expertise or Six Sigma belts comes with lot of expertise, not a lot of knowledge. They have undergone lot of projects. So why to hire these people when you are aware what the problem is? Which in most of the cases, most of the management will be having that capacity and capabilities to sort out this problem. So no question of bringing in Six Sigma. The Six Sigma comes only in the picture when you are the management is not able to identify the problem. What exactly is going wrong? Why I am arriving with so many of the defects in my product? Why my customers are not happy? So if you are not aware what is happening in the process, so there the role of Six Sigma will come into picture. And it depends, you can train your people so that what will be the costing, rightly asked by Amber, the only investment will be training your employees, jo bhi training dena padega. Aaj apan jo you people are listening to me can be first step of this particular training. What you are learning right now, probably you will be taught this only if you want to acquire white belt, which otherwise will cost you not less than 10,000 if you go with ISI, that is Indian Statistical Institute, which happens to be there in Delhi, which happens to be there in Bangalore, which happens to be there in Mumbai. So these people, they do have courses depending on the course, right from white belt to the black belt, they charge somewhere around 10,000 to 75,000. So this is the first step of getting into Six Sigma, and it is all, let me tell you, it is all about philosophy. Nothing, no equipments has to be purchased. All you have to do is train, orient your manpower so that the things in the direction of Six Sigma only. Customers remain the focus. You are all customer centric. Every day in and day out, I'm thinking about my customer. What will make them happy is the core concept, and which I think we all are aware. I'm not telling anything new to you. But bringing in this philosophy requires leadership. It requires leadership. It requires willingness of your employees. You have to orient them. Communication will come into picture. If you are able to tell them in a simplified way, simplified manner, because most of the people do have expertise in their own field, particularly talking about employees, they won't be able to follow this concept. So you have to make it very simple so that they follow what you are telling them. And you have to impose on that this is going to be good for the entire organization. This is going to be good for the entire organization as well as for the individual, those who are working on it. So this, coming to a technical part, these are seven basic quality tools. I won't be going into depth of it, but these are the tools which are, all tools are actually deployed or employed or used to find out the deviation. See, basic cause and effect. What are the causes and what are the effects? Cause means problem, right? And what are the effects? How this will deviate my product from the standard which I have set for myself. Flow chart, again, to find out if my scooty is not starting, then probably my flow chart will be, first thing I'll be checking is whether I have inserted the key in my slot or not, and whether key is on or not. If it is on, then my flow chart will say, check out the fuel, whether your tank is full or not, maybe, or whether it is having the fuel in it or not. If it is there, probably I need to check my spark plug. Even if it is not running, then probably the next step will be, the flow will be to take the vehicle to the garage, right? To show it to the expert. Here it will be Six Sigma black belt or Six Sigma green belt or Six Sigma master belt, depending on the severity and gravity of your problem. So it depends on this. Just a moment. Okay, fine. So this I won't be going because this required explaining. As I said, there are 26. These are the core quality core tools I'm talking about. Pareto chart is there, which talks about putting the most problematic area in a frequency bar. So here it is. Can you see my cursor? Pareto diagram. Here, if you see, this is the frequency distribution, and which is the most defective element in your process. All of you can see my cursor. Yes, can you see my screen, Mukund?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So this Pareto chart is nothing but putting your problems in the descending order. The severe, the most problematic area first, then second and third, and again putting it in cumulative fashion in a line chart. Histogram again is nothing but sort of normal distribution where you try to put the problems you are having in a fashion like you have a certain problem in X shift and Y shift. Control chart talks about the lower levels and the higher levels of your deviation. Scatter diagram will talk about what? It will talk about a correlation of one independent variable on another dependent variable. That is variation. See, all this will be talking about what? All this will be talking about the deviation or standard deviation. Six sigma is nothing but standard deviation. And this, all these quality control tools are applicable to DMAIC, the first methodology which we have talked about, right? Control, right? And this required, this there are more than this. Kaizen is there, then we have whatnot, POKA, Yuki is there, Kanban is there. Almost there are 26 tools which can be used for this lean as well as for the Six Sigma. I think we'll need a separate session if we would like to discuss on this particular topic. So I won't be going into much depth of it, but the core concept that you have to remember here in mind is this: all this tool talk about standard deviation so that you can analyze it properly and you can put your problem in the right perspective. Now let's come to the barriers, right? 11 barriers to Six Sigma. Now all these barriers or barriers we call it, or limitation we can call it challenges also. What are the challenges to Six Sigma? Disadvantages also we can use to a certain extent. What are these 11 disadvantages or 11 limitations? These 11 limitations are lack of resources. Just kisne pehle pucha tha, sir, what is the amount of money involved? How much I should invest? Financially, again, as I said, not much of the amount is required, but you need to train the people. Utna to kharcha karna hi padega aapko. If you say that even I am not able to do this, willing to do that, I am not going to hire consultant because they are very costly. I am not going to train my employees on this particular philosophy, then you won't be able to implement it thoroughly, because financially you need to put certain inputs. Human participation is very important, and you have to commit certain time to this concept, to this particular philosophy. If you are not committed, then probably you cannot bring justice to this particular concept. So that is first this thing, challenge. Second is internal resistance. As I said, this particular concept, again, I'm going back to the question asked, what about stakeholders? As I said earlier, this is more of an introvert sort of concept wherein you focus on the production in terms of product and services. There is bound to happen an internal resistance. Why? Because people are not aware about this concept. They don't know how to implement it. They feel that this is very technical. They feel that this is bound to replace their skills. They have to learn new skills. Let me tell you, fine, you have to acquire certain new skill, but that won't be out of the way, right? People were reluctant of using desktop when they were habitual to using the typewriters, but slowly and steadily people started accepting it. Similar is the case with mobile phone. Earlier, our parents or grandparents, they stick to the landlines. They said, this is all rubbish. Mobile phone is very addictive. People keep on just logged into their mobile phone. And nowadays, talking about Android, WhatsApp and all whatnot, social media, we are all hooked to this particular platform. But slowly and steadily, everybody is using it. The age is not the bar now. Even old age person is WhatsApping the things to their friends and relatives. When it comes to festive season, everybody nowadays, the fashion of sending greetings, hard paper or mailing something, by sending something by post, has altogether gone away. Now what we do is immediately we share a good image or we SMS the thing on our mobile phone. And that's all. Earlier we used to post through all those greetings on this festive. So resistance is bound to happen, but slowly and steadily, if you have orientation program, if you tell them the importance of this particular philosophy, then definitely that internal resistance is bound to go away. Lack of leadership. I was talking about this lack of leadership earlier also from the top executive. If there is no willingness from the top executive, or when we talk about management, if these people are not aware, if these people do not know the philosophy behind this Six Sigma, if they do not know the importance, if they do not know what sort of changes this particular philosophy is going to bring into their organization, which we can talk as a lack of leadership, this will act as a barrier to the implementation of Six Sigma. After that, lack of knowledge about Six Sigma, I have touched upon this particular point. This says you are not aware of the concept in itself. So how are you going to implement it? Insufficient organization alignment. See, as I said, it's a holistic thing. Implementing Six Sigma in part cannot happen. Ki ek department mein laga diya aur baki department waise function kar rahe, so it is not going to happen. It is not going to go that way. You have to apply this particular concept in a holistic fashion. It will be applicable to the entire organization, not to a particular unit or not to a particular strategic business unit, we call it, or not to a particular department. See, if HR me laga diya because there was problem in recruitment, then my problem will get sorted out. No, it is not like that. You have to make it applicable thoroughly, in toto, with the entire organization. In that case only, you can get the actual result of this particular Six Sigma. Cultural barriers. This comes into picture when we talk about multinational organization. Amazon, for example. Yeah.
Mukul, we are not able to see your screen, sir.
Okay, just a moment. I'll try to share it.
We can see your video, but not your screen, sir.
Okay, I think I lost it. I'll share it again. Fine. Yeah, can you see it now?
Yes, sir. Okay. Fine.
Cultural barriers, right? This barrier are bound to happen if particularly talking about Amazon, for example, because Amazon is not limited to a particular country, or for that matter, TCS, Tata Consultancy Services, they are not limited to India. They do have their offices in New York. They have their offices in London. So this cultural barrier is bound to happen if the organization want to implement this Six Sigma. And how it is going to happen? Because every culture has its own limitation, or its own their own standards, right? So many times it may happen, like Amazon coming into India, they have to target the customers who are in majority. Like they focus their promotions, particularly Diwali, they are very aggressive. Compared, it is not that they are not aggressive on Christmas or Eid or other festivals, but they are very aggressive because they know the potential customer in India actually enjoys Diwali. Most of even people from other castes, they celebrate Diwali, right? Similarly, Christmas is also celebrated by other community. So accordingly, these barriers are bound to happen, but you have to overcome this. Same type of concept which is applicable in USA won't be applicable in India. So you have to change your philosophy according to the customer base, according to the employees who are working for you. Proper training and coaching. As I said, this is poor training and coaching is a barrier, but you have to use proper training and coaching. So if you don't hire good trainers, if you do not have good black belts trainers or good belt trainers, then probably the concept won't go down with the employees, and implementing those concepts will be difficult, right? So these are all the barriers which are nothing but similar to what when there is a change in the organization. Considering Six Sigma too complex to implement, this is what even I used to perceive, ki Six Sigma kuch to bhi bahut hi technical word hai, it is something very hi-fi, we call it in our language. It will be very complex and complicated, and company I'm into service, it is applicable to manufacturing. These are all misconceptions, myths about Six Sigma, which the top management should communicate properly to all their employees that Six Sigma is not this. Six Sigma is philosophy is all about this, getting defect free product or services is the core concept, so as to see that your employees are happy, as well as your happiness of your employee will lead to a happy customer or end user or consumer, we call it, right? Wrong identification of process parameters. Now, what is process parameters we have discussed earlier? Processes, inputs and output, in between is a process. So if you are not able to identify the problems correctly, if the project goes wrong, then ultimately your suggestion will go wrong. This is something which is happens in research, right? If you are not able to identify the problem, then your entire research will go wrong, right? So identifying the proper process parameter is very important. Poor Six Sigma project selection, again, which is overlapping with the earlier, wrong identification of process parameter will happen when you select the project wrongly. You are not able to identify where exactly is the problem. Your direction is incorrect. So your ultimately your findings and your suggestions will be altogether incorrect, which won't bring the benefit of what Lean Six Sigma should bring in. Now this was what I was talking about, belt levels of Lean Six Sigma. These are all 3+3 in all, this is certified courses. And let me tell you, you and me cannot take up a project unless until we do have this base, right? Consultancy, you cannot take up the consultancy unless and until you get a certification from ISI. ISI, what I mean to say is Indian Statistical Institution, which happens to be in Bangalore, Delhi. You can go on their website, you can find out the fees, how much they charge for yellow, probably they start for 10,000. Now this is something which is very advanced, so I won't be talking much on this, but you have to remember, unlike Lean, since Six Sigma, you need to have certification. You need to take up a project. Lean, you do not need any certification. That's why I've taken up this particular slide, particular PPT. So you should be aware of this terminology. Who are the people who are involved in solving the problems, in getting the projects, right? So this belts, they do have, we start with the white belt and we end up with champions, right? Master belt is who will be reporting to the champion, black belt will be reporting to master belt, green belt will be reporting to black belt, as well as master black belt, yellow belt again will be reporting to green belt, and white belt will be reporting to yellow as well as green belt. Now here onward we start with Lean. Just I'll touch upon this concept, and I think we can call it of the day, because it's almost 2 o'clock. If you people are willing to listen, then we can go ahead, or else we can take a break and we can meet next Friday again. So yes, sir, Mukul, yes. Yeah, yes, what do you suggest?
Sir, we can stop by 2:10. In the next 10 minutes, we can stop by 2:10, and probably the morning portion we can carry on. So before that, just one query. Just I was curious about, what is the validity of these online courses for Six Sigma that is going on nowadays on Coursera, on edX, or other platforms of? So are they still valid?
See, all you have to just find out whether they are. See, what happens is ultimately, as I said, Amazon do not require any degree. Nowadays, Amazon is hiring based on your potential, based on your skill which you have acquired, based on the expertise you are having. Degree for them does not matter. Here also, same thing can happen. But if you have something, as I said, ISI, that is Indian Statistical Institution, if you have something which is certified by the government, or other certification comes from American Quality Association, right? These are all well known. This will give you validation for your certification. Online, even to be very frank, Mukund, even I am not aware, because plenty of online platforms are there which should offer you these courses. But how the other organization is going to take your degree, whether they are going to really validate your degree, if you are something which is being earlier approved by the government, probably you can make a claim now that this is being certified, right? So there are plenty of organizations, but you have to be very choosy when you are going to take up these online courses. Most of them are now offering online courses, including ISI, including Manipal University is also offering, Loyola Institute from Chennai is offering. Plenty of institutes are there. But ultimately what matters is whether you are really going to bring value addition to the organization. value addition to the customer. That is, end of the day, that is going to count. Even though I'm even though I acquire plenty of this thing, plenty of certification, but I'm not good in handling the projects, then again the validity or the use of the certificate will be limited to myself only. So you have, it's a balancing act. You need to have a valid certificate, and you need to good in identifying the problems. See, you need to be Sherlock Holmes, because a sigma first quality that comes into picture is you need to be CID. I hope all of you see this serial CID.
Yes, yes.
Anybody is there who do not see it, because I am seeing it for almost last 20 years, and these are the people who are there. They have not got a single promotion, right? ACP Pradyumun is ACP only.
Abhijit is still Abhijit.
He is still Abhijit. 20 years down the line, my children, they watch it. Who is there who has not seen CID? Because I want to talk a bit on this also. Because see, as a Six Sigma consultant or project analyst, your mind setup should be something like CID. And there is one famous dialogue. Can somebody just unmute the mic and say, what is the dialogue? It is related to problem. Anybody?
Daya darwaza tod do.
दया दरवाजा खोलो
गड़बड़
है कुछ तो है देयर इज अ प्रॉब्लम सो व्हाट दिस प्रतिभुन इज डूइंग इज ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट व्हाट कुछ दया कुछ तो गड़बड़ है सो यू नीड टू हैव अ ब्रेन और यू नीड टू हैव अ इंक्लिनेशन ऑफ सीआईडी अ शार्लक अ डिटेक्टिव और मे बी अ कॉप पुलिस जब आती है पंचनामा करने तो वो देखती है हाँ दिस इज मिसिंग दिस इज व्हाट इज हैपनिंग मे बी मर्डर हैज टेकन ओवर हियर और मे बी द थेफ्ट हैव टेकन प्लेस ओवर हियर द विंडो सीम्स टू बी ब्रोकन सो हैज अ सिक्स सिग्मा बेल्ट कंसल्टेंट यू नीड टू हैव दिस इंक्लिनेशन इन योर माइंड व्हाट इज द गड़बड़ राइट सो गड़बड़ इज नथिंग बट द प्रॉब्लम द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज फेसिंग विच दे देमसेल्फ डू नॉट नो CID की जरूरत कब पड़ती है बिकॉज द पर्सन आउट विथ हुम द इंसिडेंट हैपन डू नॉट नो वॉट इज द प्रॉब्लम सो द CID ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट द प्रॉब्लम एंड दिस इज वॉट सॉर्ट ऑफ इंक्लिनेशन और दिस सॉर्ट ऑफ थिंकिंग यू शुड बी हैविंग इन यू इफ यू रियली वॉन्ट टू फाइंड आउट द रियल प्रॉब्लम एंड इफ यू रियली वॉन्ट वुड लाइक टू सॉल्व दिस प्रॉब्लम सो दैट अल्टीमेटली यू हैव द प्रोडक्ट विच यू डिजायर्ड फॉर यू हैव द राइट क्वालिटी सेट without standard deviation. Variation should not be there. If there is a variation, then you are deteriorating on your quality, right? Even we have to talk in terms of quantity also. If I have set 1,000 as a target to be produced in a month's time, then I should be coming out with exactly 1,000 because that is a demand. Just in time says, Amazon is working on that. Unless and until there is an order, they do not produce anything. They are not a manufacturing. Manufacturer, but they are the biggest e-commerce seller. They are the biggest house. They are the biggest seller without a single inventory being maintained, without a single product being manufactured, right? So it's a very good example. They are in the top five organization in the US, followed by Apple and then Microsoft is there, right? Google is there. So they are among the top five. And how are they able to do it? All because of this Lean Six Sigma. They have made it. It's their routine actually. They have made it day in, day out. They are living with this concept. And let me tell you, as an individual also, I can live with this concept. As an organization, we can do it. All we have to do is just start thinking what will bring value to my end user and what sort of non-value added things are happening with my product, which I can eliminate, which is a part of Lean. So this is all about Lean Six Sigma, nothing difficult. For a commerce graduate or for even for a management graduate, you need not be an engineering graduate or you do not have a technical background. But if you have, if you are working for a manufacturing firm, for example, if I'm automobile, like, is a very good example, or steel, for example, if I am having a mechanical background, then typically I can pinpoint out many of the problems. Ki lathe mein problem ho sakta hai, ya assembly line mein problem ho sakta hai. But you can take up other projects which do not require your technical expertise, like service industry. A management student can always work because there are problems with people and processes in service industry. There is hardly any problem with manufacturing because manufacturing to a certain extent do not forms a major part of this organization. Service is more important. Banking, for example, healthcare, for example, there are plenty of examples. Even police station you can count it. your Dabba Walas, Mumbai Dabba Walas is again a very good example. They have implemented this, and to your surprise, Lean Sigma says how much? Four defects in a million. This Mumbai Dabba Walas is having only one defect in 20 millions. Right? One defect in 20 millions. This is the precision they have achieved because out of their experience and out of implementing the strategy, a wonderful event. So I hope, Mukund, we will take a break. We'll take a break for not a break. I just will conclude for today. What I want from my student is that all of you, I'm going to put a link. I've given a link to Mukund sir, which I want you to solve for today. It's not very urgent. You need not do it right away now only, but try to solve it so that I come to know your level of understanding of today's topic, as well as what you have learned in this operation management, so that I can touch upon the difficult aspect which you have not followed up till now, or any other particular topic which you feel that I should cover, because my style of presentation will be like this only. I do not know how many of you have followed, liked or not, but you can just put your feedback and criticism, constructive criticism I wanted, in the feedback form. And few questions I have given. You need not solve all. Koi ye final exam nahi hai, just to know your awareness and to know the level of maturity on this particular subject. I have designed this test. Aaj mujhe sirf 6 baje tak lekin aap mujhe feedback de dijiye, or you just try to solve this test so that I can prepare for my session, tomorrow's session, because I do have another session on section B, right? I hope all of you are section A.
Yeah, so this is section A, sir.
Yeah. Section A, yeah, fine. So all of you, any doubt, any queries up till now? Anything which you have not followed?
Anyone having any query, please raise your hand. I can call your name one by one and you can have your queries. And in the meantime, I have put the link in the chat box. Student guest will not be able to see, but students, you all are there, you all can see it. The link will be open there for 6 p.m. like sir said. Please respond it to next 4 hours. You can have your time. Okay, these are simple questions and put your comments. Sir, I can see one raised hand. Nishant Banerjee is having some questions, sir. Nishant, please go ahead.
Yes, Nishant.
Sir, can you explain, sir, like how have you helped organizations implement Six Sigma? Like probably give some real life cases of, like, you know, how have you helped, and probably what are the real observed business outcomes, and probably, you know, how made the executives is independent, you know, because like I'm sure like your job as a consultant would be to help them out initially and then make them independent, you know, to think along those lines.
So yeah, Nishan, I got what you want to say, what your question is all about. Let me tell you, see, what I have touched today is only Lean and Six Sigma. My next presentation will be all about your question, how to implement it. It is, I'll be talking about implementation in Amazon, which will probably give answer to this particular question, how exactly it is implemented, right? All I've touched today is all the theoretical aspects, so that your doubts and your concept should be clear. So when I talk about implementation, you should be at least well versed with this terminology. What exactly is Lean? What exactly is Six Sigma? What is wastage? So first of all, I just wanted to clear your doubts. So next, my presentation, when we meet again on Friday, will be probably on how the organization are implementing it. Right, that will be the core part of my presentation and part of discussion. I hope all of you enjoyed. Nishant, I will be answering it in the next. And in fact, I'll be presenting the question, the answer to your question. So I hope all of you have enjoyed. Tanishka has raised hand. Ambar has raised hand.
Ambar are having some questions, sir. Yeah.
Yes. Please. Ambar,
sir, and Ambar. Would you be covering these topics in detail, like Jidoka, Pokayoke, 5S, Gemba, and Andon?
This thing, add-on, and Andon, yes. We call it Andon, right? So for this, Ambar, I need actually a separate session, because as I said, it is in all it involved 26 such type of tools and techniques, and touching even a single tool, for example, Kaizen, will probably need me at least an hour, half an hour time, so maybe a full hour session. So definitely we will be touching on that also. Let me see how Mukund sir direct to me, if he give me instructions, probably we can rearrange for a few sessions if you have not followed it, because But see, this Lean and Six Sigma will form the backbone and heart of all these particular tools. And these are only tools and techniques which will help aid the organization in implementing this Lean Six Sigma. So Kaizen, Pokayoke, as you said, and Andon cards, which is again part of, I'll be touching on the Andon card. I have one PPT, one entire slide dedicated to this Andon card. What are these Andon cards? And Amazon has utilized it wonderfully well. They are using it. So other aspects also we can touch upon, but here only I'm only half through.
Also,
not
sir,
yes.
Also, sir, I just wanted to ask that is quality control just a part of the quality assurance team in a big organization, or it's a all together different procedure?
See, process control and quality control are two different aspects, right? Process control is applicable to manufacturing side so that you do not come out with defects. And quality control is something you have come out with the defects. Now, how to rectify this defect? So this is more of an overlapping sort of thing. You cannot take it as a separate entity. See, all this thing is a very holistic thing which you have to implement in toto. You cannot say that I'll just go for quality control, I'll skip process control, I'll just implement Lean, I'll skip Six Sigma, I won't use Kaizen. You have to take into consideration the product which you are manufacturing and what suits you the best, what is most suitable to your organization, which will ultimately, see, back of the day, you have to remember ultimately what is going to bring value to my customer. That is going to be the core theme or core concept of all this operation management. See, operation management is what? It is overlapping with all other domain, including HR, including marketing, including finance. It is overlapping. So what you have to say is the ultimate objective is to have a satisfied customer. So quality control, I won't take it as a separate entity, right? It will be part and parcel of each and every tools and techniques, which cannot be applied in isolation or which cannot be applied as a separate entity. You have to think about holistically, you have to take into consideration each and every aspect of the organization. Then and then only you can succeed in, because see, achieving Six Sigma is very difficult task. Forget about the financial aspect part. You have to be trained, you need to have a trained manpower, you need to have sufficient time to be committed to this manpower so that they inculcate this philosophy into themselves. So aapko raat mein bhi jagaya gaya to aapke muh se Six Sigma hi nikalna chahiye. This should be sort of philosophy that should be embedded in the employees. In that case only achieving Six Sigma will be possible. 3 Sigma and 4 Sigma you can easily go and achieve it. But getting this money defects, Mumbai Dabba Wala, as I said, even I'm not exactly aware how, what sort of techniques they are using. I've attended few of their sessions, but let me, as I said to you, they are far beyond Six Sigma. Only one defect in 20 million, that too in 2 months time. And so what can be that defect? A tiffin of Mukund coming to Mukul, right? That can be one of the defect. A tiffin going to a wrong destination because they are into service, they are not into manufacturing. So we will be talking on this, don't worry. Amber, I hope I have cleared.
Yes sir.
Okay. So we will be touching all aspects, don't worry.
What we can do, A division students, if anyone is interested or having some queries, today we are having same session into B division. So I'll be forwarding you the link of the same. And I believe you are free tomorrow at the same time. So anyone who is interested can come. Obviously, attendance will not be given. But then anyone of you who is interested to re-attend the session and get your queries clarified, re-attend the session. I'll be forwarding you that link also.
Yes, Mukul, this will act as a revision also, because white belt, definitely you can confirm on them. Once they are familiar with this terminology, you can always say, I'm a white belt consultant, right? Because you know this terminology. So directly you can jump to yellow belt, right?
Agreed.
So getting yourself certified as a yellow belt, Mukund has rightly pointed out, Mukund sir, ki certification from ISI, if you are good in this, all this terminology, getting a yellow belt won't be that difficult. So take it as a revision, or if you have certain doubts, you can again log in tomorrow. I hope I'll be able to clarify, but I'll be repeating same thing again, and I'll be stopping on this slide only, Lean. And next session we'll be talking about Lean and Lean Six Sigma, and we'll be talking about Amazon. Thank you all. Thank you so much for your patient listening. I hope I have satisfied all of your doubt. And if anything remains, I do have Mukund sir do have my mobile number, my email number as well. You can post your queries on my WhatsApp number. You can take down my WhatsApp number. It is 98231-41467. 98231. I'll repeat it again. 98231-41467. It is my WhatsApp number. You can post any of your queries and doubts so that we can be interactive. See, session in all is okay, fine. It does have its own limitation. I wanted to explain lot many things today, but because of want of time, we won't be able to cover everything in this 4-hour slot. So I'll be more than happy if you can communicate your doubts. Okay. Thank you,
sir,
all.
Thank you so much. WhatsApp number in the chat box, sir. So all they all can see it.
Okay, fine.
Yeah.
Okay, Mukund.
So before we leave, thank you so much for the today's session. In between, I had a word with few other students. They are quite happy. They found it very interesting.
Thank you for the
next session. We'll be coming again. Thank you so much, sir. And students, all of those who are there in the session, I have already downloaded their attendance and have already given attendance to them on the portal. Okay.
Yeah, Mukund, just remind them of the feedback again, please.
Class, feedback. Yes, sir. As Dr. Burgatti had said, please ensure filling up the form before 6 p.m. today. Okay?
Thank you all. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. So I'm stopping the meeting, class. Okay? Thank you so much.